The sign gifts aren't going on today. When you understand those truths, you will understand the all wisdom that God has given you today. Turn with me quickly. We'll end in Ephesians 1. Look at verse. You remember when we looked at that word, I said to keep that word counsel in your mind. Look at Ephesians. Look at Ephesians 1, verse 8. Wherein he hath abounded toward us in all wisdom and prudence, having made known unto us the mystery of his will. Get it? The mystery of his will. According to his good pleasure, which he hath purposed in himself, that in the dispensation of the fullness of times he might gather together in one all things in Christ, both which are in heaven and which are on earth, even in him, in whom also we have obtained an inheritance, being predestinated according to the purpose of him who worketh all things after the counsel of his own will. God has a counsel, and his counsel to you and I today is revealed by the Apostle Paul. And if you go and follow after anywhere else, you're not in the will of God. And that's just the truth of it. Praise God, we have his word, and that you can hear his word today and believe it and get with the program. Understand what God is doing today. And as Paul says, that the fellowship of the saints is important. He put emphasis on that. I hope and pray that we continue to come here and learn about these things, and those that are listening will come and learn about these things and not be tossed to and fro. I got one more passage for you. 2 Timothy. Second Timothy 4. I've been in a few churches, and in my former persuasion, and no one taught me these verses. And I'm going to read them to you. Look at 2 Timothy chapter 4. Look at verse 2. Preach the word. Be instant, in season, out of season. Don't change anything. It's the same thing all throughout the season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long-suffering and doctrine. Listen to this. Heed this warning. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers, having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth and shall be turned into fables. Folks, just as those false prophets were turning the people of Israel away from God so that they forget his name, that blows my mind. There are teachers today that are taking away from what God would have to tell you today about the dispensation of the grace of God and Paul as your apostles, as your apostle and the mystery of Christ. There's teachers today that are heaped up from people because they have an itch in their ear. They don't want to hear it. They don't want to hear the truth, but hear just their own carnal desires, as we looked at 2 weeks ago with Ron. Heed that warning and believe the word of truth rightly divided as Paul reveals it. And you can recover yourself from the snare of the devil if that's where you are. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for your word and that it reveals to us the truth. But not the truth in just the sense that all we have is the truth and we can't really know what's not truth and what is truth. But that you've revealed to us the lie, the what we're not to follow after. I pray that we can see these things clearly and choose to hear your word and believe it. Not kick against the pricks, not to remove tradition, remove division out of the way, and hear what your word says and be united in what you teach to us today through Christ, through the Apostle Paul. Father, I thank you for the word that you reveal these things and what great doctrine that we are going to get into next month in revealing the details and the mechanics of the dispensation of the grace of God. And that it's to us Gentiles, it's for our glory, Paul says, faint not at my tribulations. Faint not at what he went through to give this doctrine, for it is our glory. Why anyone would want to kick against the dispensation and grace of God, and Paul as our authority, Paul as our apostle is beyond me, because it is for our glory. We thank you for your glory. We thank you for your Son, for all wisdom. We thank you for the riches that we have in your grace. It's in Christ's name we pray. Amen.